you can throw some of your questions. We will try to respond to your questions. Any question. It is not that it should be necessarily on this subject. I spoke, actually, when I came, I wanted to have only question answer session. Then somebody requested, they should know what they should expect from you. Just for that, I spoke few words. You can come up with any question. You don't have to feel whether it's the right question or wrong question. Yes.
Meditation. When you meditate, whatever it is, when I try to meditate, I find it difficult to see what I should focus on. I mean, I see a lot of things that maybe have taken place, maybe in the past day, on the past week, or over the month, or things like that that take place around me, and I get immersed so much in those thoughts, I'm not able to focus. So, how do you develop that? I mean,
your first question. You say, when I meditate, I'm not able to focus on the thing which I want to. Meditation is not concentration. First thing you need to understand, what you are doing or what you are trying to do is concentration, not meditation. Meditation means to create enough of energy so that thoughts subside by itself. You go beyond the level of mind, you go beyond the level of thoughts. It is not fighting with thoughts. I tell you, if you sit with closed eyes, you will have more thoughts than when you walk around. You will have more thoughts. What you are trying to do is concentration. You try to focus on one object, try to eliminate everything else from your mind. Concentration, not only it is not going to help you, around the world, in all the tradition, I tell you, all the tradition which has taught concentration made only human beings as dull. Only logic goes towards the concentration. In logical mind, according to logic, if you see, if you concentrate on one object, leaving all other objects, you always think you get the knowledge about that object, but never. It is a very superficial truth. It is a very superficial truth. You never get knowledge by concentration. You get knowledge by awareness. By awareness. There is a subtle difference between concentration and awareness. Concentration is like a tensed project. You will be totally stressed. You will be continuously under the tension. Awareness is more or less like a relaxation. You will be totally relaxed. Automatically your mind will be centered. Awareness is like a looking at a rose. Concentration is like using a sword. You are tensed. You need too much of, I can say, either removing something from your mind or putting some idea inside your mind. Do's and don'ts. Too many rules. Too many do's and don'ts are needed for concentration. But for meditation, you don't need too many do's and don'ts. Whatever you are doing, whatever your routine is, just you need to only improve your awareness. Improve your concentration. Improve your awareness. As a byproduct of awareness, concentration may happen to you. Concentration may happen to you as a byproduct of awareness. Meditation is more towards awareness. If you are sitting, feel the seat, feel the weather, feel the people around you, feel whatever you are having or whatever you are feeling, feel the present moment. Just be in the present moment. That is what I mean by the word meditation. But whenever you try to concentrate, you have to eliminate something or put something in your mind. It's like a chemical process. It's like a do's and don'ts. Do's and don'ts will never work. Concentration is for conscience. meditation is for consciousness. So only for logical mind concentration is necessary. For illogical mind, I said not illogical, illogical, beyond logical, you need meditation. Meditation is beyond logic. Not, it is neither logical nor illogical. For logical mind only, you need concentration. So better, you try to live every moment inside your body. In your life, you can see, if you are in the university, you will be thinking of your apartment. If you are in your apartment, you will be thinking of the weekend. If you are in the weekend, you will be thinking of coming back to the university. So wherever your body is, your mind will not be. If you are here, you can be sure your mind is not here. That thing can be very sure. If you are somewhere else, you can be sure your mind is somewhere else. Your mind never stays where you are. If you start living where you are, if your mind starts staying inside your system, then meditation starts happening to you. Meditation is not a routine or a part-time. Meditation is not something like a quantity to be added to your routine. It is the quality to be added to your whole day. It's not an half an hour job. Half an hour job is concentration. Meditation is a 24 hour thing which needs to have a little bit of training or little bit of understanding. More than a training, it's an understanding. When you start living the moment to moment, the level of awareness increases. Level of awareness only is meditation, never the concentration.
How do thoughts arise due to interaction with the inner world or the outer world or the combination of both?
It is interaction of the inner world, interaction of the outer world and both. Thoughts, let me explain. What is thoughts? Actually, it's like a small stone if it is thrown on a lake. Just the waves are created. It gets expanded, expanded, expanded and reaches the end or the boundary. Same way, any idea, either from outer world means a new thought, new information. If it is dropped, it creates a wave. From inner world means some memory. The experiences or the ideas, informations which are already collected inside your mind. If those experiences or if those informations, if they come up again, ripples or waves are created. You can never silence your mind from outer thoughts or from inner thoughts. You can never stop your mind from the thoughts. You can create such a consciousness or energy which will not make you affected by the thoughts, which will elevate you from the thoughts. Only that is possible. You can never try to silence your mind from the thoughts. If you try to silence your mind from the thoughts, the thought to silence the mind will become one more thought. That will create one more ripple. That is why the people who try to concentrate instead of meditation, if you try concentration instead of meditation, you are always in a struggle. It's like you try to pull your shoes to fly. By pulling your shoes, can you fly? No. So you can never concentrate your mind by your mind. If you create awareness, if you create energy, if you express your inner layers by a proper technique, then you will see the whole water will be dried. The whole lake will become empty. Then there will be neither water nor ripples. Only that space can be reached. You will be totally empty. You will be totally relaxed. Only that space can be reached. Never the thoughtlessness by concentration, beyond thoughts, only by meditation.
How is it possible?
Yes.
How is it possible to be living in the society that we live, to have a lake that is without water? You have to survive. You have to. You have so many people to take care.
One thing. Your idea about without thoughts means it's something like a totally dead. A whole day you will be sitting with your eyes closed. That is what you are thinking. Am I right? What do you think as a thoughtless mind means? Tell me.
You cannot. What I'm saying is you cannot have a mind without thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
And the way things are set up, the society, the place we live in, if you don't concentrate, you will not get food to eat at the end of the day. You may do things in a better way to be happy with what you're doing.
One thing, your very idea, what you say by the word that you know, if you don't have thought, you will not be able to get the food at the end of the day. Your very idea means without thought, you will not be able to work. It is totally wrong. Now, you understand few things. Without thought, you will be able to work more intensely. Two things I'll try to explain to you. One is chronological tomorrow. Planning for tomorrow. Another one is psychological tomorrow. Worrying about tomorrow. 90% of your thoughts are psychological tomorrow, not chronological tomorrow. Let you know, understand few things. Planning about your future, planning about your things to be done is creativity. But worrying about the things to be done, worrying about the tomorrow, worrying about the future is psychological tomorrow. Your whole energy, your whole disturbance, your whole mind is based on psychological tomorrow, not on chronological tomorrow. Plannings or creativity never makes you tired. Have you seen an artist becoming tired? Have you seen a man who paints becoming tired? Never. You think he doesn't have thoughts? He has thoughts. He has got only chronological tomorrow. He has no psychological tomorrow. In the life also, 90% of your thoughts are nothing but psychological tomorrow. If you understand the difference between these two, psychological tomorrow and chronological tomorrow, you will be able to understand mind can be alive, man can be alive without thoughts. When you are alive without thoughts, you will see your efficiency is more. Small example. Now, for example, if you see a rose, if you see something when you morning, when you walk out of your house, when you see something, if you see a rose, your mind says a word rose. Immediately the next thought will be the roses which you have presented to somebody, or the roses which are presented to you, the roses which are rejected, are the persons associated in your mind with some roses. Your mind will create a chain link such a way continuously you will forget the real rose and your mind will be thinking of the roses and the persons associated with the roses. You will forget the reality. Your mind will be spinning around in the thoughts. Either some worries associated to the thoughts with the associated to the rose or some other thought associated to the rose will be there, but you will miss the reality. What I say, whenever you live the reality directly, whenever you live the reality without the word rose, when a child looks at a rose, he never creates the word. He never creates a chain link. He has no past load. He has no continuous thinking. He has no continuous verbalization. When he looks at the rose, he just leaves the rose. He is totally present. He totally leaves the rose. He never verbalizes it. He never verbalizes it. When you leave, your 99% of the thoughts never arise in your mind. Whenever you don't leave, only then you live in the mental plane. If the thoughts are too much, you will not be living in reality. You will just miss the reality. If you understand this one example, the living with the rose, or any moment, any time, any situation, you will see most of the time you live only in the words, you live only in the thoughts, you never come down to the reality, you never relate with the reality. Most of your energy is spent only in thinking about psychological tomorrow or worrying about psychological tomorrow. By continuous thinking, by continuous worrying, brooding about the past or thinking about the future, in these two, you miss the present. The present moment is lost. The present moment is missed. Even if you live thinking about the past and the future, thinking about the tomorrow, the tomorrow is going to come again as a today. Again, you will miss that today. When you have decided to live thinking, you will see you will be missing every day. When you start living in the present moment, you will see the number of thoughts will be reduced. Power of thoughts will be increased. As of now, your number of thoughts is so much, you will not have the power to make it reality. When the number of thoughts are reduced by the awareness, you will have the power to realize or to actualize those thoughts. Now, as of now, you will be spending more than 90% of your energy only in thinking and worrying. When you start living in the present, 90% of your energy will be spent in creating. Only 10% will be spent in planning. When you live in the present moment, your whole energy turns as a creativity. If you just try, of course, logically if you analyze, your mind will never agree for it. Because logic can be alive, your mind can be alive only by worrying. Worrying or imagining about the future only will let your mind be alive. Just like every mechanism in the every person or every being in the world, mind also wants to survive. So it will never let you live in the moment. It will always give you enough of worries. There is a beautiful saying by one of the saints. 99% of your worries never comes true. Whatever 1% comes true is always good for you. But your mind never lets you understand. Your mind will never let you live without thoughts. Because without thought means mind has to die. When you drop thinking, when you start living, mind has to commit suicide. Your mind will never let you be aware or be alive without thinking. If you just give a little chance or trial to this concept, only by experience, of course, I am not telling you experience means take for 20 years, 50 years, no. Just try for a few days. Try to live every moment. In few days, surely you are not going to lose something. So try for a few days, only half an hour. Try to take half an hour from your routine. Just decide, this half an hour, let me try to live without thoughts.